matter?
I think we should stop.
Why?
I'm just afraid that we won't be able to stop.
Don't you trust me, Nan?
Yes, Andy, I trust you. It's just that I'm not sure that I trust myself.
Believe me, I love you too much. I respect you too much to let it get too far. I won't let it get too far. I just never felt this way before.
Julie? Call! Let me know what's happening.
Look, Kirk, I'm sorry.
This has gone on enough.
I don't want to be disturbed.
Look, I've been waiting nearly an hour to see you, and loyal Jane here keeps lying to me that you're tied up with some urgent phone call.
No, darling, I'm waiting for a phone call.
Well, I'm waiting to get out of here, and I have some very important notes I've got to go over with you about clients that may call while I'm on vacation.
Vacation impossible.
Well, I hope not, because I was going to be here in 5 minutes to pick me up, and we're going to the airport to pick up the kids, and then we're going out to the farm for a week of glorious relaxation and peace.
No, darling, postpone it. Let Iva take the kids for you.
No can do.
Oh, Samson without his hair. Darling, come on. Forget it. I need you. I do, actually, because this phone call that I'm waiting for, I could be in real trouble.
I'm on vacation. Okay, Jane, tell you what we do. I'll go over the notes with you, and then you can tell Lucinda when she's a little less frazzled, okay?
All right, but please, don't get too close to me. I've still got the flu.
What, she dragged you out of your sickbed, huh? That's terrible.
Go! Traitor's out, Jane!
It's phone.
Out!
Gee, I hope those sharp-tooth execs that you're interviewing are on the ball. I love the competition.
Lucinda.
Is that the girl from Packard Garrett?
No, it's John. He's threatening divorce if you don't take this call.
Why don't you just let him do it now, if that call you're waiting for is about what I think it is.
Julie, are you there?
Yeah. I'm just a little blown away, that's all.
Well, I don't understand. I thought you said you knew you were pregnant.
I did. I was just hoping for my sake and Duke's that it wasn't true.
Well, Julie, I can assure you, you are definitely pregnant. Now, I know you're leaving for Seattle tonight to be with your mom while she's ill. But as soon as you get back, it's very important that you see me to set up a series of routine prenatal visits.
Yeah, right.
What exactly did she say?
That I'm pregnant.
Yeah? Well, if you don't mind, I'd like to call her back myself. Hear it straight from the horse's mouth.
I'm not lying, Duke. I'm pregnant.
Come on, Julie. All you've been doing is lying to me. And what's all this bull about your mother being at death's door in Seattle? I don't believe any of it. All this is a scam dreamed up by old Lucy, isn't it?
No.
And Pam's father helped out, didn't he?
No, I'm not lying. I'm pregnant. Why are you treating me like this?
Brought to you today by Mountain Grown Folgers Coffee. Folgers, the best part of waking up.
Darling, why are you being so sharp with me? No, really, John, here I am in the middle of chaos. I'm making horrendous decisions here at the office, and everyone's a traitor and has left me in my moment of need.
Well, actually, what I have been trying to find out is if we still have plans for this evening, but I'm too exhausted now to even care.
Have you spoken to Duke, dear?
Listen, what's going on? You asked me that earlier.
Well, it's because I care about you, darling, and I know how worried you are about Duke. And of course, I care about Duke, too.
Yes, yes, I'm sorry. Yes, well, I am worried about him. I haven't been able to find him. He's been out of the hospital most of the day. And when I did track him down, he's damn near snapped my head off because I asked him if it had anything to do with Julie. Thank you very much.
You're very welcome. What did I do?
No, not you. I was thanking Susan. She just gave me a cup of coffee. It's great. It's just the way I like it.
Oh, well, darling, I'm afraid I can't make any plans right now. Everything is so chaotic here.
Okay, then I will make plans for myself and Duke if I can find him.
All right, darling. Well, if things change here, I'll certainly find you. I love you. Bye-bye.
Yep, there you go. Well, congratulations on plugging up that leak. Good luck with the rest of the dike. Now, how about some hugs and kisses and congratulations for a vacation well-deserved.
No, can do.
Oh, no, come on. No, you know, I love you. I'm crazy about you. I guess that must make me crazy, huh?
They all say that when they go on vacation. Aww. Hey, I'm crazy about you too.
Yeah.
Have a good time.
Hi, Jane.
Thank you. All right. Ta-da! The vacation has arrived. Ready to go pick up the kids?
If you are.
Ready and raring. See you next week, Lucinda.
No, you'll catch my flu bug.
I am so high right now that I'm not susceptible to any kind of negativity. Adios, adieu, auf Wiedersehen.
It's nice to see them so happy.
Forget him. He's on vacation. And I am all alone by the telephone, waiting for Packard Garrick.
I have never seen you so concerned about one new contract that you haven't even signed yet. What's so important about it?
Don't ask, Jane. I can't begin to tell you what's riding on this one new account.
You look so great in this outfit.
Damn.
Hello? Hi, Andrew. It's your father. You okay?
Of course I'm okay. Why?
Oh, nothing. You just sounded different, that's all.
I'm fine. What's going on?
Andrew, listen, since I know you're there all alone.
Actually, no, I'm not alone. Leanne's with me.
Oh, I see. Well, look, I was hoping we could have dinner tonight. Leanne, too.
We just ordered a pizza, Dad.
Oh, I see. Well, look, I tell you what, why don't you throw it in the fridge and you can eat it tomorrow.
Thanks for the invite, but, Leanne and I kind of wanted to spend, a little time together tonight.
Andy, I'd rather eat out, if you don't mind.
All right, fine. I tell you, how about I meet you guys there at 8 o'clock at the Mona Lisa? Good. I will try to find Duke, see if he can join us. Fine, Andy, I'll see you there then. Bye-bye. Golly, it's like pulling the teeth with these people. How about you? You want to have dinner with Mona Lisa?
I'd be delighted.
Great. I'm going to see if I can find Duke and see if he'll join us.
Oh, he can't. Remember, he's got to take the night shift because of all the time he took off today.
That's right. Okay. Give me half an hour. I'll clean up my desk. I'll meet you right back here, okay?
Fine.
Audrey, you on your way home already?
With two patients in labor? Hardly.
You tell them to hurry it up. We all want to go home.
Sure.
Audrey.
Oh, yes.
I know the results are confidential, but did you get back Julie's test results yet?
Yeah, I did, and I called her right away with it.
Come on. You aren't any more pregnant than I am, are you? It's all a scam, isn't it? And all this bull about your mother being sick, the whole deal! You and Lucinda had this all worked out, so I'd marry you, and take you back to Seattle and leave Lucinda the happiest woman in Oakdale.
Duke, I'm pregnant. Dr. Samuels just told me.
Oh, yeah? Then I want to know how long. Come on, Julie, let's just find out how pregnant you really are.
Where are you taking me?
Tell you when we get there, but one thing for sure, we're not going to Seattle to visit your poor sick mother who's out drinking and dancing tonight.
you left with Mac and Nancy.
Hi, how are you?
I told David that I would be here tonight in case he learns what flight he's on. You will let me know if he calls.
I will, now that I know you're here.
How's my young friend Buddy doing?
Well, he looks to me like he's doing fine so far. We got two new girls in the castle today. I think he's interested in one of them.
Oh, my dear, that running a co-ed place can be really complicated.
No, I'm not worried about that. We have Gibson. He's a good counselor. He'll take care of things.
Now, Ellen, I am so concerned about this. Why did Tom want to talk to you today? He's been very mysterious.
Margot and Lila found a window open at the cabin when they arrived, and Tom wanted to know if David and I might have forgotten to close it, but I'm sure that we didn't. Tom also said that they'd gotten some phone calls with no one on the line, and Lila saw a shadow on the path, and she thought it was a man moving toward the cabin. Margot says she's sure it was just her imagination.
Oh, please, you're just giving me the creeps.
Now, you won't forget to tell me if David calls.
Trust me, Ellen.
You are pretty incredible, Caleb, going to see Lily and the new home.
Well, it wasn't easy.
I know, but you made it look easy, and I'm proud of you.
Well, I figured if I wanted to keep Lily as a friend, I had to admit the fact that she's married and very much in love with Derek Mason. Did you notice how that guy Jeff kept watching her?
Honestly, no. No, I didn't notice anything after Brock called me.
And how did Brock know that Craig was away?
I don't know. The only thing I can think of is that maybe you heard us talking.
Well, you too.
Hello.
I'm here for Kirk and Ava's party, so I'll have
dinner. Actually, no. That's a very special party. Just wait till you see.
You're right.
Oh, well.
We just need a table for two.
For two?
Yeah.
Just two.
Thank you.
You're uneasy about James, aren't you?
Well, logic insists that he has used up his nine lives, but if he did manage to survive that helicopter crash in New York Harbor, you can bet he'll be back here to settle all scores. It worries me that he knows how much I care for Shannon. And Emily as well, for that matter.
Barbara and Paul wouldn't be safe either.
Poor Paul. What a bloody horrible legacy he left his only son.
Dear Emily, I really miss you. It's still hard for me to put my feelings into words, even in a letter. I'm worried about you now that you're seeing Brock again, after he's hurt you so much. It's weird, but in a way, maybe I should be grateful to Brock. And to my dad, too. Because if we both hadn't been hurting so much that night, I might never have known
what it was like to love you and to wake up next to you.
Hey guy, your mom's on the phone. She wants to talk to you before she goes out to dinner.
All right. Hi, Mom.
Duke. What's going on? I saw you bring Julie in here.
Dr. Samuels is giving Julie a sonogram right now.
Oh, so Julie is definitely pregnant.
Oh, yeah. Only I want to find out how long she's been pregnant.
Good. You're a quick study. I'm proud of you. Let me know what the outcome is, okay?
Hey, listen, Susan, without you, I don't think I ever would have thought this through. I mean, by now, I'd be in Seattle and married.
Oh, no. You're too smart for that. And look, whatever happens in there, we'll find a solution. I promise.
Thanks. Okay.
Must have been hard to leave your girlfriend Julie in Seattle. Do you miss her terribly? I have some business to attend to in Seattle.
Oh, yeah? What company are you dealing with out there?
You wouldn't be familiar with it, dear. And I'll see Pam while I'm out there, and I'll meet her father.
So, how
how long she's been pregnant.
Does it really matter, Duke?
Yeah, well, it matters to me, and I'm not leaving here till I find out. So why don't you give the Dr. Samuels the okay to tell me? Go on!
Julie is just over 2 months pregnant.
You weren't even here 2 months ago. And I sure wasn't in Seattle.
It's over. There is no way I can be the father. Julie is more than 2 months pregnant, which means I was in Oakdale and she was in Seattle.
Oh, Duke! Duke, that is such good news. I'm so proud of you. You really hung in there until you got the truth. That's great.
Yeah, well, there's still a little bit more truth yet to be discovered. And I think I know what it is, too.
Well, for crying out loud, if it isn't my son, and he doesn't look like he has the weight of the world on his shoulders.
Yeah, I'm feeling a whole lot better, Pop.
No kidding. Well, then maybe you can tell me what's going on here.
I can't, so, but up.
Your father and I are going to go to the Mona Lisa for dinner, so why don't you get the chief of staff here to spring you for the evening and join us?
Nah, I gotta get back to work, because all the time off today. I think it is better that I keep busy now.
Tell you what, look, you make it up some other night, okay?
Look, man, I told you I don't want any favors because I'm your son, okay? How many times I gotta tell you that?
Okay, well, I'll see you at home later, then.
I don't think so. I'm working late, you know?
So I'll stay up. Huh? Oh, excuse me.
Duke, you know, you can call me at the Mona Lisa or at home if you want to talk. You promise?
I will. Thanks. I just don't want my pop getting hurt in all this.
Why would he?
So, ready to go?
Oh, sure.
Okay.
Sure. I'll see you tomorrow.
Okay.
Okay.
Listen, I'm sorry you're not coming along with us, but I want you to know it makes me very proud that you are willing to put some time in tonight to make up for what you missed this afternoon.
Okay. Well, I'm proud of you too, Pop.
Good night.
Night.
Yeah. Good.
Good luck with those deliveries.
Thank you, John.
Okay.
Hi, is Julie dressed yet?
Dressed and gone.
Gone? Where'd she go?
Well, I don't know, Duke. She was very upset. She said she had some business to take care of.
All right. I think I know where she went to take care of that business.
I'll bet it's difficult.
Ellie, would you quit looking at the guy? Now, he's going to think that you're showing interest, and eventually he's just going to pull up a chair.
I don't have to show interest, Caleb.
Ellie, I thought he was real tight with Emily.
He is, but I'm still a challenge to him.
Well, I'm glad to have this opportunity to tell you how very special your granddaughter has become to me.
Well, I think the feeling is mutual.
Good.
But Emily's been through a lot. I would hate to see her hurt again.
I can assure you I won't let that happen.
And your divorce?
The divorce is almost settled, I'm very glad to say, if that makes you feel easier.
Well, I must say it does.
Good.
Ellen, even with my poor failing memory, I did have to remember you're still here. You have a phone call. It's in the foyer.
Thank you, Lisa. Just excuse me for a moment.
Of course.
Andy, I'm so surprised to see you. Where's Leanne?
Oh, Leanne's upstairs changing. My dad called and he said he wanted to have dinner here with us.
And you're not very happy about that, are you?
Well, no, I'm not. I expected to have an evening alone with her.
Oh, you're young. You'll have many evenings. Oh, many wonderful evenings. Don't you worry, okay?
Hi,
how are you? Lisa Mitchell. This is Lenore Barkley.
Hi, it's nice to meet you.
Steven and Linda Ann. This is the owner of this wonderful place and my landlady.
Hello, Steven. And hello, Linda Ann.
What's a landlady?
A landlady is, well, to him, it's like trying to be his mother.
Come on.
All right, follow her.
Hey, guys.
Hey, the gang's here.
Yeah, you think the farm's going to be able to handle this whole crew?
Are you kidding me? The chickens have been laying extra eggs all day.
Lenore? I'm so glad that you and the children had a safe trip.
Well, Uncle Jared.
Hi.
Of course I came straight to you.
Come on, pick
it. I don't know what to do next.
Darling, do next. There's nothing to do next, all right? It's done. It's all been done. The only thing we can do is to get you out of here and back to Seattle as soon as possible. Let me see. I guess Duke didn't tell John. I guess he doesn't want to. The gynecologist, let's hope and pray, has a Hippocratic oath to consider.
Also,
huh?
Duke is sure that there's something going on between you and me and Larry Wagner.
Well, forget about that. Forget it. There's no proof. There's not going to be either. Oh, God. Now I've got to find a new way to rid my life of this kid.
Hey, what about me? My life is ruined. I can't even go back home because Duke talked to my mom.
Oh, now buck up. You're a good, strong girl. You'll be all right. You can handle things, and this is going to certainly make them feel better. All right, dear? Just have to be out of Oakdale tonight. The jet is free. I'll send you back to Seattle on the jet.
Wait a minute. This is not what we agreed on, Lucinda.
What are you talking about? It's exactly what we agreed on.
Oh, no.
No!
That was before I lost Duke and before I had no place to go. I want 50,000 more.
Wait a minute, darling. You can't fail at what you're doing and expect more money after you made a mess of things. Come on.
Just try and find someone who can. Right. Well, the final piece of the puzzle falls neatly into place.
We'll continue with part two of As the World Turns in just a moment. As the World Turns.
That's quite a picture. Or are the two of you meeting? Because now Lucinda wants to offer you a job here.
I'm sorry, Lucinda. I tried.
It's perfectly all right, Jane. It's all right. Go on. You go back to your desk.
Thanks.
This poor girl has come to me very upset about her growing dilemma. Come to me because I've been kind to her for your sake, Duke, and she has nowhere to turn.
Nowhere to turn. Right. I'll buy that.
Mm-hmm.
Man, you've been really messing with my head for the last couple of days, so why don't you do something decent for once and come clean? Hmm? Oh. There she goes again, doing that little signal behind the back, just like she did at the yacht club that day when my father offered you that check. I believe she made you turn it down, too, am I right?
That's so ridiculous. How would I know that John was going to try to buy Julie off? And how could I get her to turn it down?
Oh, we've been through a lot, me and you. We've even had some good times together. But listen, right now I'm going to need you to tell me the truth, and there's going to be no hard feelings later. It was Lucy here that set this up in Seattle, am I right? I don't believe this. Listen. I believe my pop offered you 50 grand that day. That offer still stands if you come clean.
Oh, darling, don't fall for that. That's the oldest trick in the world. My check is in the mail. And Duke, you know, you should think. Grandiose offers of money that you don't have may just buy you what you want to hear, whether it's true or not.
You just think you're better than everyone else, don't you? Everyone on Earth is just walking along, and you're just riding high on your roller skates. Well, you're trying to con the wrong guy, lady. I grew up on the streets. I know every scam there is. And I realize this hasn't been any better roses for you either, but look, Julie, I don't blame you, okay? I know you wouldn't have teamed up with Lucinda or Larry Wagner unless you really were up against it.
I think I've had enough. Why don't you leave, Duke? Or if you need help, I'll call security.
Right, and I'm going to go straight to my pop. Look, Lucinda, I'm going to make you a deal right now, and it's only because I care about my pop and I don't want to hurt his feelings. So, this is my best offer. You ready? I am willing to forget the whole thing and give you what you want. Yeah, that's right. I'm going to move out of the mansion, but I get to know the truth. Now, Julie, I don't believe you're a bad person for doing this.
I know what it's like. You've had a lot of bad breaks in your life, but I'm gonna need you to come clean. I'm gonna need you to tell me that Lucinda dragged you into this, that she conned you, and I promise you, you will get that $50,000 so you can start your life over again.
Why should I believe you?
Because I've been straight with you every time. Even the times when you didn't want me to. And you believe that I still care about you no matter what happens. Hey, I see she gave you a little something there. Well, I'm willing to bet that it's not so much now that her great plan has fallen through.
He can't promise money he hasn't got.
I am so right in this! Julie, am I right in this or what? I mean, this is your big chance, Julie, to come clean, to even the score. It was Lucinda who started all of this in Seattle, didn't she? Lucinda has been paying for all of this, your plane ticket out here, your new clothes, your new hair. Come on, Julie, this is your chance to come clean. Am I right or what?
Yes! Yes, yes, it was all of her idea. I never would have come to Oakdale if she hadn't come to me in Seattle. And now she's trying to go back on her promise to me.
Thanks. I won't forget that you came through for me when it really counted.
Hi, Jenny.
Listen, before my dad gets here, I just want to let you know that I wouldn't have let things get too far back in my place.
Yeah, I know, Andy. It's just, I mean, it scares me when I find myself so out of control, you know?
Hello, Andy.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm real glad the two of you could join us tonight.
Yeah, oh, I thought Duke was coming.
Well, Duke is working a little late this evening because he took some time off.
Why is that?
Beats me. But I wouldn't be a bit surprised if Julie had something to do with it.
So, how is Barbara doing in Dallas?
Oh, the promotion for Barbara Ryan Originals went really well, but they're still going to stock Olivia Simply Barbara line.
Oh, well, tell her not to worry about that. Just Barbara must concentrate on the beautiful new house and get settled in there and having that baby you do want so much.
Good idea. I will tell her. Listen, have you heard from Margot?
Yes, I talked with her earlier, and Tom is spending the night with her and Adam. In fact, he arrived while I was talking on the phone.
That's strange. I talked to her earlier. She didn't mention it.
Well, you see, it was all a surprise. My son is so romantic.
Oh, Lisa, I asked David about that window at the cabin, and he's just as certain that we didn't leave it open. Need for you to take me out to
my
the...
What's this about a window?
Well, Marga and Lila discovered the window open in the cabin when they arrived there, and they were a little upset about that.
They think somebody broke in?
Well, no, nothing was really missing. But then they got a little nervous about things because they got phone calls and no one was on the line, and then Lila was sure she saw a shadow of a man on the path.
Well, Brock's gone. You're safe now.
Good. I'm going to go to the powder room now that it's safe.
All right.
Thank you.
Oh,
really? I'm so surprised to see you walk in here, Uncle Jared.
You know how much I love Oakdale, so when I heard you were going to bring the children down here, I just decided I'd try to arrive and coincide with your visit.
So how did you know we were here?
Called the farm. Emma told me.
Oh.
Hey, Stephen, you know, there's something that the Snyder Pond has at the ocean festival. Bullfrogs, and we're going to try and catch some.
Will you be there, Mom?
Now, I explained that to you, Stephen. I've got a lot of things to do back in Maine, so I'm just going to stay the night here at the hotel, the one where we stayed before, and then I'm going to go back home, and I'll wait there for your father to fly you home.
Stephen, I know you're going to miss your mom, but Ivan and I have got so much planned for you and your sister. You'll be so busy, you'll be back in Maine before you know it.
That's right. He has a lot of things planned, not just catching frogs.
Did you plan this?
I won't be sorry to see the last of this place. Who is it?
It's me. May I come in?
Don't worry, I'll be out here in 5 minutes, so you can go ahead and have the place fumigated.
I'd like to talk to you.
Yeah, well, I got nothing to say to you. Except that using someone's desire to get something is about the lowest dirty trick I can think of. Especially when that person playing the trick has got it all.
Julie wasn't wholly accurate, you know. I think she wants to put me in a bad light.
I really gotta hand it to you, you know that? You're a fighter, you don't quit. And I respect that, even if you fight dirty. Okay, listen, I'm not taking anything that isn't mine, so you don't have to watch me like a hawk. Actually, I'm kind of glad I didn't take my pop up in that offer to get me new clothes and other stuff. I like to travel light.
I'm afraid you're determined to think the worst of me.
Not really. You know, I can't even really hate you. Not even after you used Julie to try and get rid of me.
You don't hate me, really?
Come on! Look, all I ever wanted was a little honesty out of you, you know? Maybe level with me, I don't know how many times I tried to ask. All you had to do was say you didn't want me around here and I would have been gone. But I don't know. Maybe you didn't believe me, or maybe you were scared or something, I don't know what, but, of course, maybe it has something to do with John. And I'll tell you, because from where I stand, lady, you got the world by the tail and a husband who loves you despite all the tricks you play. Man. Yeah, we really could have worked something out, me and you know? I don't know, some kind of, you know, crazy little relationship, stuff like that, if you just give it a half a chance, but no. Oh, hey, listen, you have to worry. Like I said, none of this is going to get through to John. At least not through me. Yeah, I've really gotten to kind of love that guy. And I don't want to see him hurt. But I am going to ask him for that 50 grand for Julie. And I'm going to make sure I pay him back every red cent. No matter how long it takes. I feel sorry for you, Lucinda. I really do. You said you grew up poor, just like me. I guess somewhere along the way, your values got all twisted up. Anyway, thanks for the lodging. I guess we now realize why the apartment pool house was never finished. Am I right?
You going to Seattle with Julie?
No, I'm not going to let you get off that easy. I'm going to stay.
Yeah?
Because I got myself a great pop and a terrific brother, and yeah, I got an honest chance to get what you got now. And I just know one day I'm going to be able to step back and enjoy it. Too bad you can't.
I wasn't being devious. Come on, I called your office. Your secretary gave me Lily's number.
I think I know you better than that.
Well, I know you too. I know some things about you you wouldn't want printed on the front page of the City Times. I wonder if Craig will ever know you that well.
He already does.
Come on, all those very special little Ellie Snyder things? I doubt it.
Only because your ego can't bear the thought.
Okay. I really meant what I said. I hope we can become friends someday.
That's not possible.
Everything's possible if you want it bad enough.
I guess I don't want it. I hope Emily gets back soon so she can keep you occupied.
Yeah, I was going to go to New York to have dinner with her tomorrow, but her grandmother's going to visit her, so I've postponed my trip.
You don't really want to go to New York, do you? You have too many enemies there. They might think you're there on business.
You worried about me?
I don't want to see you dead.
Well, that's a start. Thank you for that.
Ellie, you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine, thank you. Good night, Brock.
I'm just going to call the farmer, okay?
You know, if I didn't care for your sister so much,
You'd be dead long ago.
I heard about the window at the cabin and thought of James as well.
So, all I'm asking you is if you've heard anything new from your contacts.
And I repeat, they've sent me nothing. I've told Paul, I've promised him, that if I hear anything about his father, I'd let him know right away. And I meant that.
Well, I'd appreciate a call, too.
Fine. Let's see.
You do know something, don't you? Duncan, please, even if it's only a hunch.
Paul, we hardly see you anymore.
Well, it's a pretty tough job getting him out of that office.
Yeah, but who could resist having dinner with my dad, huh?
Well, it's the first time I ever heard you call me that. I think I like it.
You know, with all this talk about my real dad, I think I like it, too. So, how have you guys been?
I'm having a wonderful summer.
Yeah, me too. I've been really busy, though. I like it.
Not so busy that you didn't find time to write a letter. Do you believe I caught him putting pen to paper before? No. I'm pretty sure it was a love letter.
Give me a break, Cal. Come on, let's see. See you guys later.
See ya.
Sweet picture.
So, Stephen, I think you're going to be able to get to know Iva a lot better this week while you're visiting.
Excuse me. You have a phone call from Lucinda.
Tell her I'm on vacation.
Oh, take it. It can't hurt.
All right. I'm tempting the fates. I hope you know that.
Excuse me.
Sit down for a
minute. I'm on vacation. And why are you calling me while your husband's here with Susan?
Oh. Well, I'm sorry to bother you, Kirk. I just need to know if and when Duke comes looking for John.
Wow, you don't sound too good, boss lady. I can tell. Guess everything hit the fan, didn't it?
Oh, thanks. Duke, what's happening?
That's a long story, but look, I'm here at work, so I'll tell you later. I just wanted Andy to know that I moved my stuff out of Lucy's place and over to his place.
Well, Andy left here about 10 minutes ago. But why did you move your stuff over to Andy's?
Well, I promised I wouldn't tell my pop, but I guess it's okay to tell you. Lucinda engineered the whole deal with Julie.
What?
Yeah. Julie confessed. She spilled everything. It seems that Lucinda flew her out here to put her up to tell me that she was pregnant to get rid of me.
Hi. I know you'll hate me for coming here, but I didn't know where else to go.
I hate you. Why would I hate you? How'd you get in here?
Duke once showed me where you hid the key.
Oh. Julie, what happened?
Tonight was the worst night of my entire life.
Is it your mom? Is she okay? Because I heard that she was having heart trouble. Is she all right?
That's part of it. But it's not like you think. She lied to me. It was all a lie. She just wanted to force me to go back home.
You're kidding.
And that's not the worst part.
Julie, what do you mean? What?
I was praying that you would come back before Duke. He was going to tell you some horrible things about me. And then I'm going to lose the only friend that I have in Oakdale.
Julie, listen, I make up my own mind about people, and you're terrific, okay?
Shh. Do you know how special you are? Handsome. How good.
Julie, no,
I can't help it. I can't help
Julie.
It.
Julie, please don't cry.
Julie.
wrong? Something's bothering you.
It was just that tonight at Andy's. Well, we were very close. And I just got afraid, and I pulled back, and I just don't think he's going to be feeling the same way about me.
I promise you one thing. If Andy really cares about you, and I'm sure he really does, nothing's going to change. Why don't you go upstairs and take a wonderful bubble bath, and I'll be up soon, and we'll have a good talk.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you.
Yes, my darling. Okay. Bye, Susan? What? Bad news?
I'm not sure about that. It might be the best news I've had in a long time.
Emily! I'm so glad you're there. I'm at the Mona Lisa having dinner for one, and I must tell you, Oakdale is a dreary place without you.
Is that the hospital?
No. John, I think you better give Duke a call.
Why?
He moved out. He took all his stuff over to Andy's, and I think he's feeling pretty lost.
What do you mean he moved out? Come on. You know, all day I've had the feeling that you knew something was going on here. Come on, I rely upon your honesty. What happened? Tell me.
This portion of As the World Turns has been brought to you by Mr. Clean. He leaves nothing behind but the shine. Stay tuned for Guiding Light, next on most of these CBS stations. Fashions by Betsy Johnson. This is Dan Regan, inviting you to join us again Monday for As the World Turns. This is...